have found that 80% of the population is under the age of 30. So that may not be a problem as you speak, but talk about your observations about what's going on in the kingdom.
Is kingdom of Saudi Arabia really causes an enigma to the government of this region? And people who are familiarized with it can file this regime for some time. And in the wake of the Arab uprising in 2011, that countries by and large bypassed the turmoil. The question is, for how long will the current Arab regime continue to work? If you look at sort of the number of indicators across the spectrum, we seem very concerned. We see the chemicals. We see an economy that over the near term is going to diversify to meet the needs of the population. We see new trends in how people are relating to their government and their willingness to criticize them. Much of this is enabled by social media. And I think this is a really revolutionary development in this country where the government is trying to regulate discourse by controlling the press, by controlling the media. And you're seeing social media really empowering people to have a voice in their government. Whether that really forces some sort of political change, I think remains to be seen, but it is a remarkable development. Added to this, there's a great deal of frustration in a number of regions, especially in the East, with local governments, in terms of how the government is managing infrastructure, services, especially when you compare it to other parts of the world, which, and this is quite visible to some casual visitors, are doing much better in terms of infrastructure and services.
When you talk about the East, is it true that the dying by the Shia population within Arabia?
Yes, that's where the majority of the Shia world is comprised, about 10 to 15%.